Hello YouTube friends. Today, I'm going to show you how to make a portable bench power supply. It's really easy and affordable to create. All you need to make it is a 3D printer and a soldering iron. If you like the video, please consider following my channel and sharing it with your friends. I have several bench power supplies in my workshop. Let's take a look before we begin. If you're not interested and want to skip straight to the assembly, you can skip the video until minute 5. I purchased this power supply at a flea market 10 years ago. It has been consistently useful, but its analog display is not very accurate. To adjust the voltage precisely, I must use a multimeter. Additionally, this power supply lacks an ammeter. I frequently use a bench power supply that I made by combining an old computer power supply with the ZK4KX module. This module is a buck boost converter with a display. I used this wiring diagram. In the video description, you will find a link to the schematic and all the components used to make it. The ZK4KX module is very affordable and meets all my needs. You can adjust both voltage and maximum current using the two buttons and potentiometer. Then I have this. It's always made from an old computer power supply. Besides being a power supply, it is also a battery charge and discharge station. It can charge up to 318650 batteries. It has a fast charge USB output and two classic 5-volt USB outputs. A micro USB cable turns on a ZB2L3 module to discharge and measure battery capacity. The power module is the XHM229. This module is super cheap and has only one power switch. It has four fixed output voltages protected by fuses. In this case, we have no display and no regulation. Documentation of this project can be found in the video description. When I am not in my lab, I often require a power supply to test my projects. However, the power supplies I have are too bulky and heavy to move around. Some time ago, I purchased a board for less than 5 euros. I immediately realized that with some modifications, it could become a great portable tool. It is nothing more than a compact DC-DC buck boost converter powered by USB. Of course, we can also use it with a regular power bank. By turning the potentiometer, we can adjust the output voltage from 1.2 to 24 volts. Unfortunately, this little power supply only delivers a maximum of 3 watts. This is not much, but it is enough to power a small project or a microcontroller with a sensor. Just below the screen is a small button that turns the power on and off. The same button, when held down, turns the screen off completely. There is a micro USB connector on the top of the board. Other models of this board have other types of connectors, such as USB-C. At first glance, I found it more convenient to use this connector. After using it for a while, I realized that it is quite inconvenient. In fact, since it does not have a stand, To see the screen clearly, you need a vertical surface to rest it on or use it with two hands. Also, it would be more functional to have different connectors like banana plugs. To add a stand and more professional connectors to the board, you need very few components. Two banana plugs, two M3 screws 12 millimeters long, some 3D prints. I printed all the parts in under 2 hours. The STL files are available on my Thingiverse profile, and the video description includes a link to them. Additionally, the video description lists all the materials and tools used in the video. To stay updated on the tools and components I use, subscribe to my Telegram channel. It's time to assemble our power supply. First, unscrew the banana connector nut. Next, let's set aside this thing that I don't know how to say in English. Then, prepare two small wires, each about 2 to 3 centimeters in length. After that, solder the wires onto the things that I don't know how to say in English. Finally, reassemble the connectors and tighten the nut firmly with pliers. Set aside the connectors and take the 3D printed parts. Connect the two larger parts to ensure they fit together, then screw the two M3 bolts into the side holes of the hinges. The board fits perfectly into the printed part without the need for glue or additional support. Next, we will properly cut the wires that were previously soldered to the banana connectors. After that, we will insert the wire into the screw terminal and press the connector into the hole. The 3D printed objects are designed to firmly fix the connector. Repeat the same process for the second connector. Finally, insert the cap and screw the terminals to complete the power supply. I almost forgot. I also printed this knob, which definitely increases the usability of this little power supply. To finish the job, I bought these modular cables. They are very useful because with one cable we can connect to many different connectors. For now we only need banana plugs and alligators. The power supply is ready for final testing. The LED lights up and the potentiometer changes the light intensity, indicating correct connections. Now let's check if the voltage displayed is correct. The power supply shows 3 volts, while the multimeter shows 3.075 volts. Let's try another measurement. The power supply shows 3.6 volts and the multimeter 3.625 volts. There is a voltage discrepancy of less than 0.1 volts, which may be due to the display rounding the value. Despite this, it still performs well as a backup power supply or for hobby use. Overall, designing and assembling this small portable power supply was an enjoyable experience. Due to its compact size and compatibility with power banks, this device is ideal for low-power projects outside of my workshop or in outdoor settings. I plan to replicate this project using the more powerful ZK4KX module, which includes an ammeter, for more advanced projects. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much for your support. Don't forget to follow me here on my YouTube channel and subscribe on my Telegram channel. Ciao ciao.